Hello friends, this is Apurva the Book Hunter, and today I will be talking about two political non-fiction books based on Indian politics. The first one is called One Life is Not Enough, an autobiography by Mr. K. Natwar Singh. He was a bureaucrat in the Indian Foreign Services, and then he later went on to become a politician in the National Congress Party, and subsequently he was ousted from the Congress Party because of corruption charges. So this was a very controversial book written by him. It created a lot of stir. But honestly, I'll give you a fair warning. Stay away from this book, because it should be aptly named One Lie is Not Enough. This book is nothing but a vain glorification of the rotten bureaucrats and politicians of their time. It has this narcissistic narrative style that really hurts your intellect. I mean, what is he thinking? What was he thinking? The modern Indian populations are not to be fooled so easily. They can detect a lie and differentiate it from the truth. In fact, sometimes it feels as if he's trying to insult the intellect of the reader. And I don't see any reason to waste your time or money on this book. As far as the writing style goes, it is fairly good, because the author has a lot of books under his name. He's a well-learned person. But as far as the contents goes, I would really resonate Sonia Gandhi's comment that it is absolutely rubbish. But at the same time, I have no intentions of reading Mrs. Sonia Gandhi's autobiography either. That is going to counter it, because that would be another rubbish. After reading this book, I have developed a distaste for political autobiographies, and I don't want to read anymore. I don't want to waste my money or time on this one. I do believe that all the politicians in Indian politics at this point of time are absolutely corrupt, and so are many bureaucrats. So I think I will not be reading any of the books written by these people anymore. But however, the second book that I'm going to talk about is a very interesting one. This is written by a journalist, Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai, and it is named 2014, The Election That Changed India. This is about the Lok Sabha elections of the 2014, in which the BJP party led by Mr. Narendra Modi, who's currently our Prime Minister, swept up the Lok Sabha elections, won every Indian's heart, and proved their dominance over every political party in India. So this is an interesting study of the political campaign and all the political scenarios and backgrounds that led to this ultimate victory of BJP, and the way it analyzes and explains all the political complexities of Indian politics is quite mesmerizing, I think. I did detect, however, a little bit of a anti-BJP sentiment in this one, but I don't think it is the opinion of the author. I think he stated a lot of truths, and these truths really hurt the BJP. Sometimes this is the nature of the truth, really. Sometimes they will hurt BJP, sometimes Congress, sometimes all the political parties, but truths will be always be truth. And I really like this book because of that. It struck to the truth. It also described how the current political scenario has a lot of dependency on the free market, capitalism, and the choice of the businessman. So I think it's a very engaging read, and if you will give it a try, I don't think you will be very disappointed. In fact, I was really mesmerized to read this book, because I really wanted to know how Narendra Modi captured the hearts of millions of Indians, and he broke their hearts afterwards. So the 2019 elections are almost knocking at the door, and I think this should serve as a reminder for anyone who reads it, and it will absolutely be it will be a great book to read in view of the upcoming elections. So friends, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up and leave your comments below whether you like my video. I will be back again with another video on another book. If you want me to review any book you want, or you want my opinion on any book, or whether you should buy it, please let me know in the comments below, and I'll try my best to obtain it, read it, and tell you in details about it. Signing out, this is Apurva the Book Hunter. See you next time.